today. I'm going to introduce my friend, and she's given me a few bullet points. I know y'all got gifts because the program's set up, you got to give us those. Chick-fil-A people last time. I thought that's pretty good. But you might have something to talk about also. But let me introduce my friend, Dr. Lesley Kirby, in her official capacity. Dr. Kirby is the PD region's very first doctor of audiology and the owner of the only private practice of auditory. She's the only hearing person who has her own secret field. She received her doctoral degree in audiology from the Arizona School of Health Sciences. Dr. Kirby has served as president of the South Carolina Academy of Audiology and was appointed by South Carolina Governor to help write legislation on governing audiology practices in our state. Along with lifetime hearing services in Florence, she also has a facility in Hartsville and Lake City, and is currently in the process of opening another facility in Charlotte. So if you have hearing issues, she's the way to go to. I took my dad there, and he was very hesitant about that, but she helped him out, and I'm very thankful. Now here comes the cool stuff. I actually met Lesley through her husband, who's not her husband at the time, by selling him horse food way back in the day when I worked at Goldkin. He was just a regular country bumpkin who I loved. He's always been very friendly to me and just a true southern gentleman. He had a few qualities I kind of like, you know, redneck. he's just a great guy. And then to have such a polished young lady to come along, and they make such a beautiful couple. They have two children, a son who is 18 now, which is crazy to me, here, and a 12-year-old daughter named Kelsey. This is what I think is more cool than that. Other than they are a beautiful Christian family, she's one of the most giving ladies that I know. We're Facebook friends, we're friends in real life. I'm always seeing where she's honored somebody who works for her or a friend or something like that. But something you may not know that I think makes her cool is about her dad. He played on the 76ers with Bill Chamberlain. And he also played for the Chicago Bulls. He also helped coach the Milwaukee Bucks and the Chicago Bulls, so that makes her thoughts to me. We've got a little different program. We're going to tag team this a little bit about the different organization we're first you're a part of. And I'm going to let Lesley start with that, but can y'all help me by welcoming my friend, Dr. Kirby?
Thank you. Sunday of every month in Florence at Palmetto Street Church of God. And it's non-denominational. We want every Christian business owner to try to attend this meeting. And it is such a neat networking organization because so many different, I mean, I'm involved with a lot of networking organizations in Florence as well. But most of them are either geared like Rotary, where you help out in the community, or B.R.E.A.T.H.E, which is another one that I'm involved with, where it's trying to get business brought into your organization. You know, how can you help me grow my business? That's what B.R.E.A.T.H.E is about. B.R.E.A.T.H.E is more about giving thanks to God for your business. Because I honestly believe that one of our most precious gifts as business owners is our business. And it is a gift. And we need to stop and breathe and give him thanks and glory for our businesses. So it's a whole different concept to networking because we're not focusing on us. Instead we're turning that and we're giving thanks to him. So there are generally two parts to our meetings. The first part is we have a pastor, Pastor Brad Lewis, or another pastor from any denomination, come in and actually give us a mini sermonette about what the Bible says about business. How are we supposed to treat our employees? If we have to dismiss an employee, what is the biblical way to do that? Okay? When you have to hire an employee, what is the biblical way to do that? Ethics, morals. So every month, we're always getting some word into us about what the Bible says about business and how we are to conduct ourselves as business owners and leaders. The second part of the meeting is we want to be that light out in the community. And one of the little things that I had our group do, one of our meetings, I had everybody bring a flashlight. Remember that? Everybody brought a working flashlight, that was.
Or a cell phone.
Or a cell phone. They could use their cell phone. And go find a spot out in the sanctuary somewhere with your flashlight and turn it on. And that is symbolic of all the different businesses all around our area. We have a light over in that corner, and over in that corner is a light. And some are dim way in the back, you can see it a little bit, and then others are really bright. But what happens when all those flashlights start moving in together and start working together? It becomes a beacon. It becomes a very strong light that people are drawn to. And that is the concept of greed. It's how we as individual business owners can work together to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ out to our communities. And that being said, do you want to talk to them a little bit about what we're doing? Okay.
Well, one thing that Greed does is, outside of this, we have throughout the past year, we've had different charitable organizations go in and give a little presentation about what they do and how they impact the community. Y'all know I'm a mobile county girl, that's pretty good. And I'm very protective. I'm also very loyal, so I'm like, okay, how can we get someone here too? So, but it's not just a Florence charity or something like that. It's something that we touch throughout the city region. And they'll come in and give a little snippet about what they're doing. For 2 years now, Palmetto Street Church of God has hosted, it's kind of like their big fundraising event. And they've had it at their church. And they use the proceeds that they raise off of that. It's not putting anything in the business owner's pocket at all. Nothing ever comes back to the individual business owners. It is about how we can collaborate and get a little juice out in the community. And so they had David Phelps at their church last year. Was a sold-out concert, like, way ahead of time. And they outgrew that. And so this year, it has moved to the Civic Center in Florence. Not the entire Civic Center, hopefully down the road, God willing. But it has moved into what they call their uptown ballroom, which will seat 1,200 people. And so this year, that's going to be rolled out and announced all over the PD and Columbia and the beach and everything like that. This year, that they have Danny Goki coming. And I don't know if you've ever heard that name. Danny Goki was on American Idol. And he was a runner-up a few years ago. Part of his story is that 1 month before he went on American Idol, his wife passed away. So he was faced with a decision, you know, do I go ahead? You know, how many people make it to get on American Idol? And so he had done that.
and he has used that as part of his testimony. He has had he's had a country hit song. He has had country pop songs. He is very all over mainstream Christian, and he had a number one selling Christmas album last year. So this is a national figure. And one thing that's cool about him, which I think is cool from my standpoint, is he's just a regular person. He's like me or you. You know, God is with me, and I feel him every day. And so I feel like we got somebody who's got a God-given talent who brings you in, and they're singing songs that you've heard off of, you know, secular radio, Christian radio, and then he gets to tell you his story, and you realize, you know what, this is somebody who's just like me, who's lost it, needs Jesus, and he's using that platform. So we've been blessed to be able to bring that in, and the concert's going to be November the 17th at the Civic Center, and this is how God works. I had someone lined up. This is how it impacts us here in Marlow County, because I think it's a group effort. I had, just like, thank goodness, the co-op sponsored last year, our corn days, and we got publicity out of that, and we tried to give them some props back, and thank people help on a small business. And we have, and still to this day, try to give the props out for them for doing that. So I had somebody lined up, because number one, I didn't have any income last year, because if y'all remember, it rained. It just quit raining this year. As a matter of fact, it's still raining in a form of that plant yet. So y'all better get prepared. But one thing that was so cool is that I had someone lined up to sponsor my mates, which can cost about $5,000. Which would be cool because it's not coming out of Rebecca's pocket. Doesn't mean a thing, but that allows me to try and use my, you know, expenses elsewhere for advertising and trying to draw people in our county and create some revenue and job seekers. Well, you know what? They had bad year too, so they weren't able to sponsor my next. I thought, what you want this sister to do? And then I thought, well, you know what? I wonder if they would consider if I wanted to put any ghost space in our home. And I thought that'd be a good way to publicize the concert because it rolls out in the proper time for the time it's needed to be advertised. You know, September, big in October, preparing for your first concert of the holiday season in November. And I asked Lee about it because I thought they might be like, me. And I'm like, do you think anything you'd be interested? Well, he was all over that. And so we had to get permission to use his face and his likeness. It was very difficult to deal with. He said, as long as you give me a picture of it, I mean, there are other maids who do this, and there are all kind of legalities that have to be drawn up. And all he asked for me to do was give him an aerial shot from a phone. And I'm like, heck yeah. And so he's going to be publicizing his face from a Harper's farm on all of his nationwide. And so I'm very thankful for that from a business standpoint. And honestly, I think that's a blessing from God to me, but that was not my intent at all. So we're very excited for that.
Yeah, so anyway, the proceeds from our concert are going to be going to the House of Hope with the PD to help with the homeless. And also we will be helping fund Danny's foundation, Sophia's Heart, which is named after the wife that passed away. And he also, Sophia's Heart is also for the homeless in Tennessee and in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. So funds that we generate here are going to be helping not only local homelessness, but national homelessness as well, which is really special. And we're going to have an ultimate silent auction at the event as well. And you have to have a ticket to be able to participate. But we're doing brainstorming last night. It's going to be really, really good. So just wanted to stop by and tell you about the organization B.R.E.A.T.H.E. You all are welcome. Any business owner is welcome to attend. Or if you are a decision maker in your business, you are more than welcome to attend too. The third Monday of every month at 6 p.m. at home. I know it's a little bit of a drive, but let me tell you, God certainly appreciates you taking the drive. I think on your tables we have some information about B.R.E.A.T.H.E. as well as lifetime hearing. So I appreciate you all for having us today. If you have any questions, ask Rebecca. Yeah, call me.
I got one question, Rebecca.
Yes, sir.
What would be the chances of getting this Danny guy to do a concert at the Marlboro Civic Center?
It would certainly be a possibility. There would be funding because she emailed me something. She's like, I need something for Danny Doty. And she's like, I'm in Doty. And she would be the one who's been in a lot of that one-on-one contact, but I can certainly ask her and reach out and we'll see about doing that.
Especially since, I mean, his faith is going to be here.
The Civic Center, that's what last night she was asking me. Well, she was telling me, she's like my general person. We're going to be on Cecil Chandler on the Carolina Company. They have that lined up. That'll be October the 18th. And they're working on having a call-in where Danny Doty's going to call in live to the show. There's going to be media and press rolling out. There has been, there's been a lot of faith here. There are three main sponsors, and part of their sponsorship was to help fund the cost of having Danny Doty there. And I'll be honest with you, let me throw this back and breathe. I go to a lot of different meetings. I sit in Columbia and Paul meetings. I sit locally in Paul meetings. They think the cathedral is like it'll be back to life. I get 6 weeks on that. And I drive over there. It's not always the easiest one to get away to because it's starting when you're closing. But I have never been and left in a long heck that I go there. As a matter of fact, it gives me time to sit down for 5 minutes and push back and say, okay, Lord, it ain't about trying to get that hole fixed in my floor or my house that's falling apart. It's not about trying to get another new vehicle. It's about trying to help keep my staff on payroll and trying to be good to them and good to my community. And Lord, what do you want me to do? And what do you want? What am I here for my business? And I kid about it, but it's true. You know, I didn't have an income last year. And trust me, I don't mean for me because I'm beyond blessed. There are people who don't have the place to go get my food. But there was a chance for sponsorship. There was a platinum level, a gold level, and a silver level. I didn't have an income last year, but I looked at my staff because they knew that at my farm, that my main goal was for us to have a faith family farm. And for us to always be a family place where people can come, bring their kids, not have to worry about the junk of the world, and they can have a truly great family entertainment arena. And so Dr. Kirby and Lifetime Breathing, they're the platinum sponsor. She's been the driving force in following God and His voice. That still small voice we talked about last night. And I went to my staff and I said, I want y'all to decide something. I said, they got a gold sponsorship and $1,500. They got a silver sponsorship. Y'all know we didn't have any income and it's real tight around here. Do y'all want us to do this? And they're like, what do you think? I said, it's not on me. I said, because I want y'all to understand the group effort is a team effort here. And they said, well, we want to do it. I said, which one do you want to do? They picked the most expensive one. I said, all right. You know, we wrote a check and all that. And so many different things have come back in. I'm still on paid off bills. You know, we got to get through this season. But just in that, there's been opportunities for me and my business and my staff, the Carolina Company. I wrote a little magazine article last month in Savvy Mag about agritourism, which is part of the corn maze and everything. And they're like, we want you to write this one, but we're going to write one on you in October. And then she told me last night there's this other magazine that wants something. So I reckon just like what you said last night, you cannot outlive God. And that is our goal. And if you ever want to just escape for just a few minutes, take a deep breath, push back, and really think about what is it that I do when I wake up in the morning, you know, what is it there for? That's what I try to do with the hour. Anyway, but I will work on that.
One more thing. Our goal for B.R.E.A.T.H.E., do you all know that the country concert that they do at Myrtle Beach is like a two-day event type of thing? They have all the big names coming in there. Well, partnering with this Florence Civic Center, our goal is within the next 5 years to have a two-day Christian event sponsored by B.R.E.A.T.H.E. through the Civic Center, where we'll have multiple entertainers coming in. And again, our goal is to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ out to the community and save lost souls. So look forward to this building every single year. It's going to be really exciting for our area.
Thank y'all very much. Thank you. Any questions for Dr. Kirby? If you need to hear she, I will tell y'all, she did really great. My dad, I purchased two hearing aids from him, for him. We were headed to Atlanta for him to have heart surgery. I saw him crack his window. lot in our community, and in the care check, that's very precious for us. Thank you.
Spell Danny, please.
G-O-K-E-Y.
Goki.
Goki.
Thank you very much for coming today and sharing that with us. Anybody else have anything before we dismiss? Don't forget, next week is cleanup, and obviously, most people is here, and some people is not. Tonight at 6 o'clock, the fireside chat. The only way you can get past that is you got to say, duh.
But you don't get a makeup.
No, you don't get a makeup if you just say duh. And it may cost you more money if you just say duh. So that's my pitch to come to the fireside chat. Same to you. Anybody else have anything else? Not less, please stand and close.